Good morning, students. Students, we have discussed in earlier videos motion and the physical quantity, scalar and vector quantity, class 9th, physics chapter. And we have discussed the both scalar quantity and vector quantity. So, student, what is the scalar quantity? The scalar quantity are represented by the magnitude only. But if we talk about the vector quantity, vector quantities are represented by the both magnitude and direction. So we have discussed also magnitude. What do you mean by the magnitude? Numerical value. So student, vector quantity show both magnitude and direction. In magnitude, in vector quantities, magnitude, numerical value and direction, both are required. But in scalar quantity, the scalar quantities are represented by the magnitudes only. Magnitudes only. Only numerical value. Understand? And we have taken the example of the vector quantity, force, displacement and velocity. But scalar quantity, distance, speed and times. Now student, we will discuss in this video distance and displacement. So what type of this quantity? If we talk about this distance, what do you mean by the distance? And it is scalar quantity or vector quantity. And in other words, if we talk about displacement, what is the displacement? It is scalar quantity or vector quantity. So now student, let us start. What do you mean by the distance? If we talk about the distance, total length covered by an object, understand? If we talk about, you can see this figure 1.2. suppose one object is start from A. This is the reference point or origin point, and it start its journey from A up to F. So in this way we can say that total length or actual length covered by a body, A to F. So this is the distance. So what do you mean by the distance? The actual length of path covered by a body during the course of its motion. You can see the motion. What do you mean by the motion? When an object change its position with respect to time. This is the initial position. Initial means starting points or reference point or origin point. Listen carefully. Understand? Total distance covered by an object from the initial point to the final position is termed as a distance. Again, the total length, suppose an object start from the A position and reaches F. So what do you mean by the distance? The total length covered by an object from the initial position to the final position is termed as distance. And the body may move along any path. Sometime you can see A, B, then B, C, then C, D, E, D, E, and then E, F. So the body may have moved along any path. Understand? Irrespective to its direction. Sometime object can change the direction. Sometime he go in east direction, sometime west, sometime north, like this. So the body may move along any path, irrespective of its direction. Thus, the distance is represented by magnitude only. Understand what I am saying? They change any path, irrespective to its direction. There is no direction show. There is no direction show, only they cover the total length. Understand? So in this figure 1.2, you can see there is a no direction. There is no east, west. So only magnitude. There is only magnitude is showing. What do you mean by the magnitudes? Numerical value. 100 meter, 150, then 500 meter, then 1 kilometer and 1.5 kilometer. Understand? So thus distance is represented by magnitude only and is a scalar quantity. If we talk about the SI unit of distance is meter. You can see the main point, you can underline. The SI unit of distance is meter. And if we talk about the other unit also used to represent the distance according to the situation, you can see this kilometer, hai na, centimeter, millimeter also. So according to the situation or measurement also. So this includes the units of the distance, kilometer, centimeter, millimeter, etc. It is always easy to interconvert the unit of distance since these are multiply or sum multiplies of the meter. Understand? Now, consider the following example. Now, you can see this figure 1.2. A. From the A, car is moves along the following path from A to F. You can see. We have discussed now. Any object start from the A. Along the following path from A to F. So, find out the total distance covered by the from point A to F. So, how can you find? So, total distance covered by AB. What do you mean by the distance? Total length A to F. So, AB plus BC plus CD plus DE plus EF. So, total you can add. So, you can see 100 meter plus 150, then 500, then 1 kilometer plus 1.5. You can add. Understand? So, 750 plus 2.5 kilometer, 750 plus, and then you can add. How can you add? You can see this. Total length covered by an object. Total length covered by an object. Understand? So you can see this diagram. So distance, what will be the distance from A to F? Distance is AB AB plus BC plus CD plus DE plus EF. Understand? So, what is the value of the AB? 100 plus BC, 150 plus CD, 500 plus 1 kilometer plus 1.5. So, you can add this. Understand? AB. You can write here. So, total distance covered by a car from point A to point F will be how? Total distance AB, BC, 500 CD plus 1 kilometer DE plus EF. You can. So, all distance, total distance covered by an object. Is called a student distance. So 3.25 kilometer. This is the distance. Understand? So 1 kilometer is equal to 1000 meter. You can do like this. I think you know how can you change the kilometer to meter and meter to kilometer. You have studied in class 6 or 7th also. So I think you should know. If you have any problem, interconversion of the unit, meter to kilometer or meter to centimeter, any other, if you have face problem, so you tell me. I will tell you how can you change. Understand? Now, I hope you understand distance. What do you mean by the distance? The total distance, total length of a path covered by a body during the course of its motion from initial position to the final position. Total length A to F. Understand? And it's show only, this distance show only magnitude. So that's why it is a scalar quantity. It show only numerical value, no direction. You can see there is no direction. East, west, north, south. There is no direction. So that's why it is a scalar quantity. So I hope you understand distance. Now student, displacement. What do you mean by the displacement? Student, displacement is a shortest distance covered by an object. Shortest distance means shortest distance between the initial position of the body to its final position. Irrespective of the nature of the path transferred by the body during its motion. Understand? So, what do you mean by the displacement? Change of position of an object in a particular direction. To short distance covered by an object. Thus, if we talk about the displacement, it is a scalar quantity or vector quantity. Yes, student, it is a vector quantity. You can see this. In short, if we talk about the displacement, is defined as the change of position of an object in a particular direction. In a particular direction. Change of position of an object. Only numerical value change and direction. You can show the direction also. That's why it is a vector quantity. Those quantities show both magnitude also and direction also. That's why it is a vector quantity. So what do you mean by the displacement? The shortest or straight line distance between the initial position of the body and its final position. Straight line distance, you can see. An object start from the A position and up to B. So, this is a total distance. How can you find out the total distance from the A to B? Total distance. And if you want to find the displacement, so shortest distance covered by an object. So, distance, displacement is equal to final position minus initial position. This is the displacement. It can be zero. Understand? So, I will give you some example how it will be zero. And if we talk about the distance, never be zero. These are the difference between the distance and displacement. What are the difference between the distance and displacement? Distance is a total length covered by an object. And displacement is the shortest distance covered by an object. Shortest line distance covered by an object from the final position to the initial position. Distance never be zero, but displacement it can be zero. And I will give you some example related to the how can the displacement will be zero. Understand? So first we will know what is the difference between the distance and displacement. Distance is a student scalar quantity. There is no use of direction, but displacement is a vector quantity because it represented by the both magnitude and direction. Understand? So, thus it is clear that the displacement is a vector quantity. SI unit is the meter. So, displacement of a body for a given situation may be equal to or less than the distance. It may be equal or less than distance traveled by it. If we talk about the displacement can never be greater than. If we talk about the displacement can never be greater than the distance traveled by the body it. That's why the shortest between the two position is always a straight line. Understand what I am saying? Distance never be zero, but displacement can never, it will be zero. And also displacement can never be greater than the distance. So, what is the displacement? Shortest between the two point is always a straight line. So, what do you mean by the displacement? Displacement is defined as the shortest or straight line distance between the initial position of the body and its final position. Understand? So, some important cases that would be helpful in the understanding distance and displacement better. So, when distance traveled by a body is non-zero. If distance travel a body is non-zero, while the displacement will be zero. How? This happens when the initial position and final position of the body after covering some distance कौन सा है? फॉर एग्जाम्पल एन एथलीट टेक राउंड ऑफ अ सर्कुलर फील्ड ऑफ आर, अंडरस्टैंड, एंड दो ही हैज कवर्ड अ डिस्टेंस इक्वल टू द सर्कमफेरेंसेस ऑफ द सर्कल 2πr, बट ही कम्स बैक टू हिज इनिशियल पोजिशन, डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज इक्वल टू जीरो. लाइक दिस, दिस इज द सर्कुलर पाथ. तो इफ एन एथलीट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम दिस पोजिशन एंड ही स्टार्ट पोजिशन ए एंड आफ्टर अ कम्प्लीट सर्कल इट स्टार्ट फ्रॉम द पोजिशन ए, दैट्स वाई इफ इट टेक आउट द डिस्टेंस सो वी एट द all length covered by an object, but in this case displacement will be zero. We can in next video we will discuss again this displacement, how a displacement will be zero and distance never be zero. So first you read only what is the distance, what is the difference between the distance and displacement. So distance means the actual length, your total length covered by an object. You can add initial position plus final position. Understand what I am saying? Distance equal final position plus initial position. You can add. We have discussed, not? We have total also. We have add all. But if we talk about the displacement, it is a shortest or straight line distance between the initial position from its final position. We minus the both position. Displacement is equal to final position minus initial position. Understand? So in this way distance never be zero, but displacement can be zero. And distance is a scalar quantity, but displacement it is a vector quantity. So I hope you understand what is the difference between the distance and displacement. Okay, students, bye.